The question you get, well, why should I care? You know, how does that affect me? But when it comes to food and agriculture, everyone can relate.
Usually like have the furrow leading to kind of like right here, right? So I'm kind of carving out where I'm actually going to insert the sensors right now. So try to make the part that you're actually going to insert at as flat as you can. And I might do some adjustment here after I make it.
We're at the Arkansas Valley Research Center, and today we're holding training for technical assistance providers that are helping us install soil moisture sensors across the state. These technical assistance providers are helping us install meter group soil moisture sensors and sample soils, and those soils will be analyzed for various soil health metrics. Our major objective is to understand these producers that implement a new soil health practice on their field. So all of these producers are trying something new. We want to be able to measure the effects of that new practice on soil moisture dynamics and soil health, those biological, chemical, and physical characteristics of the soil and how those are changing throughout time, and understanding how their yield might be shifting as a result of implementing this new soil health practice. So incorporating a particular cover crop, for example, how successful was that? What were the costs associated with that? And how quickly was I affecting soil health? And was it going in the right direction? How quickly was I changing the soil moisture dynamics? And where was I able to store more water as a result? And so taking these bits of data that we're collecting, their own experience on the ground, all of that helps the producer themselves better understand whether this is something that could work for their operation.
If this was perfect, right, that wouldn't have happened, but you can see it didn't actually affect where the insert happens. And then also that important part I talked about, when you pack it in, that's gonna get filled in with the pack. If we get good quality food, and the food being data, whether it's the soil data itself where we install these systems properly, or the soil sampling is done properly, like with the proper methodology, or the microbe collections and things like that. If we get this collection of really good quality food, you never know what you're gonna find, right, from that, like what value we can eventually link for the farmer. But the farmer's job isn't to take all that food and try to digest something about it. That's our job, to find like what those value chains are, or like what algorithms or functions we can do. Different people may have different situations, even if their soil is the same, right? So you got to kind of capture all these other variables, soil moisture, soil temperature, and then you start to kind of develop a concoction of all your ingredients. And hopefully those ingredients are high quality.
We can really have a huge impact, and we can move it in the positive direction. You know, being a part of the solution, and being a part of a solution in agriculture that is totally relatable, no matter who you're talking to.